freaking up, you guys. I can't believe 2017 is in 2 days. What? But for this video, we are doing not 5, not 10, but 15 life hacks for your hair to get you hair goals. And on top of that, they're all really easy to implement. I don't know about you guys, but I am definitely a lazy person. If I can do them, you can definitely do them. And if you guys like this video, make sure you guys smash that thumbs up sign. Let's try to get to 30,000 thumbs up. And if you guys haven't already, make sure you guys check out my iPad giveaway that's going on right now. And it ends January 10th, so you still have time to enter. All you have to do is be a subscriber of mine and be a subscriber of my vlog channel, which is Life with Tiffany Ma. And just letting you guys know, I am partnered with Head & Shoulders for this video. I am super, super excited to be partnered up with them. I have had dandruff ever since I was 6 or 7 years old. I remember my most vivid memory was in 4th grade. And I remember I was just sitting in the classroom, not really paying attention because my head was so itchy. And the girl sitting next to me, her name was Melissa, she turns to me and goes, "Tiffany, your head is bleeding. Are you okay?" And I didn't even realize I had dug my nails into my scalp so much. I just remember being so embarrassed. I wanted to call my mom. And I think the biggest reason I was so embarrassed by my dandruff was because no one talked about dandruff. And I didn't realize until a few years later that so many people have dandruff. So if you guys want to check out their products, I'll leave it down below for you guys. So yeah, with that being said, I am super excited about this video. I want you guys to get hair goals in 3, 2, 1, woo! So my very first hair goals hack for you guys is buying a shower filter for your water. They're really inexpensive. I actually bought all of my friends' ones for Christmas. I have noticed a huge difference in my hair, but if you happen to not be able to find one, what you can do instead is buy a water filter and just keep it in the shower with you. What you wanna do is just fill your water filter with water and then pour that all over your hair. That way it leaves your hair really soft and manageable. So if you want your hair to grow faster, the number one thing I suggest doing is giving your head scalp massages. Scalp massages are really easy to do just using your fingertips. I personally prefer the head massager because it like tickles my scalp. I like to do this at least 10 minutes every single day. The biggest thing I feel like people forget about is healthy hair starts at your scalp, not at your ends. So if you want to have healthy hair, make sure that you're using really good shampoo. I absolutely love Head & Shoulders, and my favorite one is their Instant Relief Shampoo. I always buy the big bottle of this stuff, and this is my favorite because it has peppermint complex and tea tree essence. Whenever I shampoo my hair, it gives me this nice, tingly, cool feeling. It like gets rid of my itchiness that happens in my hair, especially during the winter times, it just gets worse. Also, this product leaves my hair 100% flake-free. So if you guys have never used a dandruff shampoo before, I definitely suggest using Head & Shoulders. I remember I was in Europe, and I went about 2 weeks without using my Head & Shoulders shampoo and I hated my hair. So then I went out and bought it in Italy. I found Italian Head & Shoulders. So if you live in a city with really hard water or you use a lot of products in your hair, I definitely suggest using a natural clarifying rinse. And what I like to do is after I take a shower, what I do is I pour an entire bottle of club soda all over my head. Literally feels like there's soda in your hair because it just like bubbles up. Another thing I've started doing, and I've noticed a huge difference in my hair, is switching out my plastic hairbrush for a wooden hairbrush with wooden bristles. They are naturally anti-static, so your hair doesn't get frizzy. And then the wooden hair bristles are really great because it moves all of the oils from your scalp to the end of your hair, so it naturally conditions your hair. Guys, still use a plastic hairbrush. What you can do is stick a dryer sheet onto your hairbrush. Sometimes the hair dryer doesn't want to work with you and stick to your hairbrush, but once you get it on, just brush it through your hair. Hair dryer sheets are great because they smell great and also they remove static. So if you're going on 2 or 3 day hair and your hair is feeling really lifeless and flat, what I would suggest doing is just parting your hair a different way. So your hair is really voluminous once you change the part of your hair, and you kind of like cheated a voluminous look without doing anything different. So if your hair is feeling really greasy because you haven't taken a shower for 2 or 3 days, then I would suggest using oil blotting sheets. I tried this out for the first time 3 months ago. I just had like an aha moment. I have a ton of extra tissue paper laying around, so cut them up into little sheets. Just like blot it in your hair. Also on top of that, it works really great for your face too. It's a win-win. Okay, I don't know about about you guys, but nobody has time to sit around for like 7 hours with plastic bags in your hair whenever you're deep conditioning. So what I like to do when I'm deep conditioning my hair is I like to split it in two, into like two little pigtails. And once I tie the plastic bag around it, I just hop into my shower and I just wash my body. And all of the steam from the shower helps my hair absorb all the deep conditioner, so you don't have to wait around 4 hours. So excited about this next hair goals hack for you guys is because it's how to get those perfect Victoria's Secret waves. These have been something I've been wanting to master for like the last 5 years. I could never, ever, ever get it, and I finally figured out how to get it. So what you want to do is start with having your hair wrapped flat against the barrel, and every time you circle your barrel, you want to twist your hand, circle again, twist your hand again, and these will give you like the perfect S-curve waves. Promise you guys will get the best Victoria's Secret waves. So if you guys have really fine but thin hair, I definitely don't suggest ever using a hot tool over like 175 degrees Celsius, which is 350 degrees Fahrenheit. I didn't do the math myself. I had to ask Alexa to help me out because I ain't that smart. And if you think about it, you don't cook your food at like 400 degrees in the oven. Most of the times it's at like 350 degrees. So why would you ever cook your hair at 425 degrees Fahrenheit? Also, if you feel like your hair tools aren't working as well anymore, it's probably because you have like a lot of product buildup on your hair tools, and it's super, super easy to clean. You can clean it with rubbing alcohol when it's completely off. So this hack has totally saved my life a million times. Every time I'm curling my hair, I feel like it's when I'm running late and I need to head out right away. But me being like the anxious person I am, I'm always scared that something's gonna catch on fire. So what I'd like to do personally to cool it down really, really quickly is to unplug my hot tool and just run it under cold water. Just make sure you only run the metal part under cool water. My stuff has yet to be ruined by it, but make sure you guys do this at your own risk, because I don't know if it's suggested or not, but I do it all the time. So if any of you guys are 90s kids like I am, you guys probably already know this hack. This is how you lighten your hair naturally. So all you want to do is squeeze lemon into a spray bottle and fill it up with water and spray that all over your hair lightly. And just go outside, walk outside, do errands, walk your dog. And using the sun, it'll naturally lighten your hair. Alright, so this is my very last life hack for you guys, and it's how to use bobby pins correctly. If you ever feel like your bobby pin is just like slipping out of your hair, A, it's probably because you're doing it all wrong. So you want to make sure that the bumpy part of your bobby pin is sitting against your head, not the other way around. And if that's not enough for you guys, what I personally like to do is I like to spray my bobby pins with my dry shampoo. It just gives it a lot more tackiness. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Hopefully you guys implement some of these. Like, let me know if you guys use them, because there's no point in making this video if none of you guys try these out. And huge, huge thank you to Head & Shoulders for partnering up with me for this video. If it wasn't for Head & Shoulders, my hair will definitely not be the same. I would have been so much more embarrassed throughout my life. Honestly, like, if one product could give me confidence, it's definitely my Head & Shoulders. I never thought about it till now, but I feel like if I had flaky dandruff hair all the time, I would be a lot less confident. Also, let me know down below what your guys' New Year's resolutions are for this year, and subscribe if you guys are new. I'll see you guys in my next video.